Embryo transfer on day 5 is called blastocyst transfer. Recurrent implantation failure patients will get good success with blastocyst transfer. Embryos formed in the tubes will come and sit in the uterus in blastocyst stage. So blastocyst transfer will get good success rate because of the good synchrony between the uterus and the embryos. I am Dr. Savita Ashok, Sakthi Fertility. If you have any doubt, you can contact us, subscribe our channel Sakthi Fertility and Health and share with your friends. On the day of the pickup, that is the oocyte retrieval, is day 0. After 2 to 4 hours, the embryologist will do the denudation. That is, he will separate the egg from the follicular fluid. Then he will do the fertilization either by IVF or ICSI, and the embryos are formed. We will keep in the incubator for the embryos to grow. On the day 2, there will be 2 to 4 cell stage embryo. And on the day 3, there will be 8 to 10 cell. And on the day 5 is the blastocyst stage. Depending upon the size, shape and the fragmentation, the embryos are classified into grade 1, grade 2 and grade 3, depending upon the quality of the embryos. If it's a grade 1, then it is a good embryo. If it's a grade 2, it will be of average quality. If it's grade 3, is a poor quality embryo. As I told you, blastocyst is the day 5 embryo. About the blastocyst, it has the inner cell mass and the outer trophoectoderm. And inner cell mass develops into the fetus and the outer layer called the trophoectoderm develops into a placenta. I'll tell you now for whom blastocyst transfer we can do is those who have the embryos with a good quality and a good quantity. That is, the number of embryos should be more and the embryo should be of good quantity. If we have good quality and quantity on the day 3, then we can do the sequential culture for next 2 days. That is the blastocyst stage. Then we can do the transfer on the day 5. And second is those who have previously failed IVF, that is 2 to 3 cycles those who have failed, then we can go for blastocyst transfer. And third is those who have the lab set up with blastocyst culture, that is a separate incubator is there for the blastocyst transfer and the embryologist should be available for doing the blastocyst transfer. If all these settings are available, then we can go for blastocyst transfer. Then about the advantages of the blastocyst culture is there will be a good synchrony between the embryo and the uterus. As I told you, the embryos which are formed in the tube will come and sit in the uterus on the day 5. So if we are planning for day 5, that is the blastocyst transfer, then there will be a good synchrony between the uterus and the embryos, and so the chances of conception is more with the blastocyst transfer. And the second is we can transfer less number of embryos, 1 or 2 embryos of blastocyst. If we are transferring, then we can get a good success with that embryos. The third is if we want to do embryo biopsy, then blastocyst is the good one because blastocyst will have 60 to 100 cells where we can take 1 or 2 cells for biopsy, then it will be an easy one instead of doing day 3 biopsy where the number of cells will be only 8. But the only disadvantage with that blastocyst transfer is we should have number of embryos, that is the quantity should be more for doing the blastocyst culture. If it's more, then we can go for blastocyst transfer. Thank you for watching this video. Please do watch all our videos in Sakthi Fertility and Health. Thank you.